Hello everybody, Happy New Year!
Happy New Year! I'm Thies.
And I'm Steven.
And we're very happy to start this year with a video exegesis. Let's start with a word of prayer to have a very good evening. Dear God, thank you that we can get together as a Connect group, and thank you that we can dive into your word and that we can reflect and discuss together. And I just pray a blessing over this evening, over the discussion, over everything that's being said. And just thank you for your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. All right. Well, Mark kicked us off
this year with a
great sermon. New week, new way.
Yeah, new week, new way. Just a small recap of his sermon. He talked about, of course, about the New Year's resolutions, but he emphasized not to have something for the whole year, but on a daily and weekly basis, that these things become really habits. And in line with that, Jesus talked about burdens, and with those burdens, he told us what to do with it, to give it to him and to find rest. And there were different types of rest where he talked about.
Yeah, like spiritual rest, mental, emotional, like a holistic kind of rest, not just lying on your sofa watching Netflix rest. He calls us to find God's rest and just give your burdens to him. That's basically on a daily basis, not just on Sunday, not just at the beginning of the year, every day. The yoke he talks about, which sounds a bit contradictory, because a yoke is something heavy what you carry, but if it's God's yoke, Jesus' yoke, then it's something you carry together, and he carries the burdens with you. So that was, in a nutshell, what Mark talked about. And he also did, of course, the example of the big balls and the small stones and the sand. So, you know, prioritizing things, putting your priorities first, and then the smaller stuff. So you could do everything. Everything would fit, and that's an important thing as well. So now we first of all want to have you read the passage, which is Matthew 11, verse 25 to 30. We'd like you to read it very carefully, reflect on it, and discuss, like, what stands out to you, what speaks to you. Yeah. And on top of that, also look at your own life last year. Like, hey, where did I really carry God's yoke? Like, where did I find his rest? What went well? Look back at the times that you really felt that you carried
where
his
it went
yoke.
Well. Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then we'll see you back later.
Okay. See you later.
All right.
Bye.
Welcome back.
Welcome back.
We hope you had a good discussion. For myself, I think I really implemented the habit of praying first thing. You know, you wake up, blah, 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 you take a shower, and in the shower, I pray. You know, I pray for the day, I pray for the people that I want to pray for or need to pray for, and that is, for me, a very good start of the day. So, yeah. So I think that is a habit that went really well, and also driving in the car often, that I think on my way to somewhere, something, that I also pray about that, where I'm going to and what I'm going to do. And it's sometimes those silly habits that you do and that you usually don't think about, or, you know, putting away the dishes in the kitchen or doing a laundry, and that I pray for my kids when I'm doing those things. And I've been implementing those mainly praying habits. And I think it's been good, as well as the Bible in 1 year. The Bible with Nikki and Pippa Gumble, which I've been doing quite faithfully. Also in the morning after the shower, you know, you get dressed and I turn on the Bible with Nikki and Pippa Gumble.
Day, whatever.
Yeah.
Now for me, it's, we started, I think, last year with the Connect group, and hooray! So that went really well, and that's also that went well because you could share with fellow believers about topics, grow together in relationship, but also grow together more towards God. And that was I think something which we kicked off, but yeah. What went really well.
Yeah, that's been a very good habit, a good
you can support each other and grow together,
yeah.
That's important.
So that's been a very good one. So now we'd like you to look at what God is saying to you through this passage, and maybe especially like, what are the burdens that you're carrying currently and that you haven't given to God yet, like where you have not found his rest yet? We'd like you to really look at those things that you think, okay, I could improve in this area, because I think I'm doing much too much on my own. And discuss it together if as far as you can and are willing to. Connect groups are always confidential, so don't worry about sharing. And then we'll see you back in a bit.
Okay.
Right?
See you back.
Have a good discussion.
Okay.
Welcome back.
Welcome back.
We hope you had a good good discussion. It's not always easy.
No, it's not an easy topic. When things don't go well, or you still keep on carrying stuff, I think we all have that, right? And sometimes it's not even you carry good stuff as well. As an example, with the Connect group where I talked about, went really well, but we grew and you grew, and then you cannot carry everything by yourself, so you need to have other people to help you carry it, right? And that's something which is really important, right? So all those things are good. And so are many, many examples where probably you guys discussed about as well.
Yeah, sometimes it's really simple. You don't even think about it. Like at work, you have a difficult meeting and you just step into the meeting, and then actually afterwards you think, oh, I should have actually prayed before that. Not with the person, of course, but just you. Or, you know, having a difficult conversation with your child and there's, you know, some friction, and I sometimes have completely forget to pray and think, oh, you know, first do it with God and not just so those little things sometimes to spread the burden, to, you know, to put his way of living, like put on Christ and not so much do it all yourself. Because I remember Mark also saying that rest means fullness of life. It's not just, you know, doing nothing. It is like, for example, the Sabbath rest is also for community, for worship. Sabbath, well, didn't mean to do nothing and to not you know, lift your feet, whatever it is. So we have to work from rest, meaning work from that God's rest. And I think that's why it's so important to start the day with God, he says, come to me. And I think that's the whole clue is there. You know, we need to come to Jesus and with everything. Everything we do.
Yeah.
Everything we, you know.
He wants to be part of everything what we do. Right?
Yeah.
To let him in.
Yeah.
We need to let him in and give him space.
Yeah. And not always strive and always try to do more, to do better.
Which is our, I think, maybe human nature. You want to do the best things, you want to have on your job, you want to perform, which is all good, of course, but if you do it from a place of rest where Jesus has got the space, has got room in your life, then it probably becomes different.
And we have to accept, and then we have limitations. We cannot run 24/7 and work all the time, and you know, we need our physical rest and mental rest, and we just need to say, okay, we can't do it all, like we did with the CG, which is actually advice, of course, to have a core team, because you can't do it all. And and that goes for a lot of things, you know, and just to start with Jesus, start with God, and go from there. So, having said that, what are things we'd like you to think about that in the coming year, because we've only just started the new year, you would like to change, or habits that you would like to implement to live more from that rest you know, to carry his yoke and not our own burdens. So think about some practical things, preferably, that you could change in your daily life that would help you to enter God's rest and live your life from that rest, your daily life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So go ahead and brainstorm and discuss, and we'll see you back in a bit.
Okay. See you later.
Welcome back.
Welcome back.
Yeah, we hope you had a good discussion. I just wanted to say or highlight that even though we live with Jesus and we carry his yoke, it doesn't mean that we're free of trouble, of burdens or problems, but it means that we don't have to do it alone, that Jesus is there with us all along, you know, no matter what happens. And that's why the yoke is light, because he's there to help us carry it. And I think that's very important, that we don't have a trouble-free life. That Jesus never said that, but we don't have to carry it alone. So I think that's all we have to say and discuss for tonight. And we really hope and pray that you will be able to implement it this year, that it will be a year of his rest, living from his rest and carrying his yoke. So let's end in prayer.
Let's pray, guys. Father God, thank you for today. Thank you for the study, that we could discuss all the things together. We thank you for last year, 2023, and we look forward for 2024. Help us with all our habits, all our wishes, our desires. I want to give everything to you. We don't want to carry everything by ourselves. And we just want to learn to be in your presence and to carry your yoke, and that you guide us. Just be with us, and we want to thank you for it. In Jesus' name.
Amen. All right. See you next time.
See you next time.
Bye-bye. Have a good week.